You're seeing a patient with a red eye.
Is the conjunctiva inflamed, or is the sclera really the problem?
But wait.
What exactly is the conjunctiva and the sclera?
That one lecture about ophthalmology that you maybe got in your training didn't break it down. I got you covered. So today we're going to be talking about the sclera
versus the conjunctiva
in under 5 minutes. Let's get it. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Be sure to click that subscribe button. So I'm Dr. Alana Jasper Trotter. I'm a board certified ophthalmologist. And if you take a look at my eye, so the white part of my eye, that is the sclera. So the sclera, anytime you see someone's eye, you see the white part. That is the sclera. That's not the conjunctiva. So the sclera is a tough fibrous structure that forms the majority of the external coating of the eye. The anterior portion of the sclera starts from the edge of the cornea, which is the limbus, and then it extends posteriorly to the optic nerve. So the way that I think about the sclera is it's almost like a shell. It's an outer covering that protects the intraocular contents and helps to maintain the shape and structure of the eye. The sclera is also where the extraocular muscles attach that help to move the eye in different directions. The sclera is composed of collagen fibers that are arranged randomly, so this helps to give it its strength and durability. The thickness varies depending on what portion of the sclera you're talking about, but roughly it ranges from about 0.3 millimeters to 1 millimeter. It's thickest posteriorly by the optic nerve, and it's thinnest near and posterior to the rectus muscles that help to move the eye. So this is really important to know clinically. When a patient sustains a trauma that puts pressure or stress in the eye, it can rupture where it's thinnest. So I just made a little paper ball of my notes. And imagine if the patient sustains a trauma, puts pressure on the eye, and there's so much pressure, the pressure needs to go somewhere, and it goes to where it's thinnest, leads to a scleral rupture. Just as an aside, when seeing a ruptured globe, sometimes we can't always locate where the rupture is exactly, especially if it involves the sclera more posteriorly and it may be hiding behind a muscle. So in summary, the sclera is the white support structure of the eye. Some example conditions include scleritis and jaundice, which is yellowing the sclera. So let's go ahead and move on to a clear structure called the
conjunctiva. The conjunctiva
is a thin, clear mucous membrane that lines the anterior portion of the sclera. So that part is called
the bulbar conjunctiva.
It also lines the backside of the upper lid and the lower lid, and that's called
the palpebral conjunctiva.
So when I was learning this, I came up with a mnemonic that's BP. So think about the BP gas station. This has nothing to do with the gas station or anything at all. But just think of BP. So when you take a look at someone's eye, what you're seeing is B, the bulbar conj. And then just going alphabetically BP down below the backside of the lower lid, as well as the upper lid, is the palpebral conj. So BP.
The conjunctiva
is a highly vascularized structure that has many functions. It helps to lubricate the eye. It also helps to protect the eye by forming a physical barrier to prevent pathogens from entering the eye. It also has immune cells that help to protect the ocular surface. Some example conditions that affect the
conjunctiva
include conjunctivitis, dry eye, which can involve the cornea and
conjunctiva,
conjunctival laceration, as well as the subconjunctiva, which is basically a bruise of the eye. So this is a cross-section of an eye. This is anterior. This is posterior. So let's start with the sclera. So the sclera is the white shell of the eye. And anterior to the sclera is the
conjunctiva,
a clear structure that covers the anterior portion of the sclera, so that's called the bulbar
conjunctiva.
And then it wraps around and covers the backside of the eyelid. That's called the palpebral
conjunctiva.
So if you're a contact lens wearer, and if you've ever felt like the contact lens slipped off and went behind the eye, it doesn't actually literally go behind the eye because of the anatomy of the
conjunctiva.
So it actually, there's like a little cul-de-sac here called the fornix. So the contact lens can't pass go. It actually moves off and it feels really uncomfortable and annoying. It doesn't go behind the eyelid. Once I learned this, like it blew my mind, but this is anatomy. Here's a bonus. Where does the cornea even fit into this? So if you take a look at my eye, you see the color part of my eye, that's the iris, that's brown for me. So if you were to draw a circle around my iris, remove a clear dome-shaped structure, that's the cornea. So now we know the cornea, the sclera, the
conjunctiva.
Eyes aren't that bad. Hopefully this was helpful. The reason I did this video is because even after going through medical school, before I started my residency training, I didn't know the difference between the cornea,
the conjunctiva,
the sclera, like there's an eye. So that brings me to, if you guys have questions, topics, anything that you'd like to learn more about, go ahead and leave it down below in the comment section. Be sure to subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video.